Danes are reportedly delighted with Frederik's choice. Family look exceptionally happy at this point in time. And no doubt, who wouldn't be? Of course, it's not just the royal family and the people of Denmark that are excited about this wedding. Tourism officials, of course, are pretty ecstatic. They are hoping this royal romance will spark worldwide interest in the city of castles and spires, once the home of Hans Christian Andersen. Ceremony, as you would expect, and tremendous tradition. But we are told that the Prince and Mary chose this cathedral themselves as their favourite choice and option for this wedding. As we all know, the royal wedding marks the conclusion of somewhat of a fairy tale after almost 4 years of courtship since the couple first met at a bar during the Sydney Olympics. And Mary will be the first Australian to join a European royal family. Lose her Australian citizenship and become a Dane when this ceremony is over and she marries Frederik, who, by the way, was once considered Europe's most eligible bachelor. He seems a little nervous, perhaps, but as he arrived earlier this afternoon, Denmark time, he was absolutely beaming and seemed like the happiest man in the world. This wedding broadcast live around the world, as you can imagine as well. Extensive security. The crowd's getting excited. It does look like Mary's arrival is just minutes away. The streets of Copenhagen, flags flying. Businesswoman and lawyer Mary Donaldson and her father appear to be arriving at the Old Lady Lutheran Cathedral. I think Frederik knows. She's here. There she is. Royal train doesn't look too long. Somewhat of an ivory gold.
Waiting for the bride.
Mm.
So of course it is a big moment, not only for Crown Prince Frederik, but for Denmark, for the royal family, this wedding here. Frederik himself has attended schools in Denmark and in France. He has spent a year studying international relations at Harvard University in the States. He has been running a marathon in New York and is highly educated in Denmark, military educated as well. One day he will be the king of Denmark. Crown Prince Frederik, 35-year-old. Seems to be touching already for the Crown Prince. The big moment, one of the big moments today. John Dalglish Donaldson leading his daughter Mary Elizabeth Donaldson to the altar, to the sound of the anthem, Sadok the priest. Music by Handel.
Thank you.
So now the wedding ceremony is underway. It's going on right now. The first hymn, the congregation sings the hymn called "The Blessed New Day, With Joy We See." Thank you. so. This was the blessed new day with joy we see. I'm sure that every Dane all over the world, whenever he is a royal or a Republican, know that hymn. It's written by Grundtvig in 1826.
Guds kærlighed og Helligåndens fællesskab være med jer alle. Lad os alle bede. Herre, vor Gud, himmelske Far,
Bishop of Copenhagen, Erik Norman Svendsen, who's in charge of the celebration and the proclamation of marriage.
Vi beder dig, giv os stadig, hvad vi behøver, og forny daglig vor indbyrdes kærlighed ved Jesus Kristus, vor Herre, som med dig lever og regerer i Helligånds enhed, en sand Gud, fra evighed og til evighed. Således står der skrevet. Da Gud havde skabt himlen og jorden, havet, solen, månen og stjernerne, planterne og dyrene, sagde han, lad os skabe mennesker i vort billede, så de ligner os. De skal herske over havets fisk, himlens fugle, kvæget, alle de vilde dyr og alle krybdyr, der kryber på jorden. Og Gud Herren skabte mennesket i sit billede. I Guds billede skabte han det. Som mand og kvinde skabte han dem. Og Gud velsignede dem. Og vor Herre Jesus Kristus siger, har I ikke læst, at skaberen fra begyndelsen skabte dem som mand og kvinde og sagde, derfor skal en mand forlade sin far og mor og binde sig til sin hustru, og de to skal blive ét kød. Derfor er de ikke længere to, men ét kød. Hvad Gud altså har sammenføjet, må et menneske ikke adskille. Og apostlen Paulus skriver, bær hinandens byrder, således opfylder I Kristi lov. Ifør jer da som Guds udvalgte, hellige og elskede, inderlig barmhjertighed, godhed, ydmyghed, mildhed, tålmodighed. Bær over med hinanden og tilgiv hinanden, hvis den ene har noget at bebrejde den anden. Som Herren tilgav jer, skal I også gøre. Men over alt dette skal I iføre jer kærligheden, som er fuldkommenhedens bånd. Amen.
The next hymn that will be sung is Eternal Father, Strong to Save. It's a wish from the Donaldson family. From Mary herself, it was the favorite hymn of her late mother. Eternal Father. Thank you.
Kære brudepar, kære kronprins Frederik og Mary Donaldson. Det må føles overvældende for et brudepar at træde ind i Københavns Domkirke i dag.
This is the address by the Bishop of Copenhagen.
Brudepar har prøvet det før, og for dem alle har det været en overvældende oplevelse. Ikke mindst for bruden, som skal gå den lange vej op af kirkegulvet, mens alles øjne spændt følger hende.
A cathedral today must be an overwhelming feeling for brides and the bridegroom. Millions in Denmark and all over the world will watch this couple today.
Da jeg for 12 år siden trådte ind i denne kirke,
and now he's explaining that when he himself 12 years ago went to a church to be consecrated bishop, he had the same feeling.
Der viskede han med et lille smil, nyder du det? Og inden jeg kunne nå at svare, så fortsatte han, det kan du lige så godt gøre, nu du er her. Det hjalp, skulle jeg hilse at sige. Midt i det enorme opbud af mennesker og medier, skal også et kronprinspar have mulighed for at nyde deres eget bryllup. I skal nyde og glæde jer over, at I har fundet hinanden og fundet sammen.
What he is saying is, to the young, enjoy and rejoice that so many are following this event with genuine interest and sympathy. You are not only today's couple, but also the couple of the year in Denmark. No doubt about that.
Symbol på liv og lykke.
You are the symbol of life and the symbol of happiness, youth and love.
Måde alle det i jeres åbenlyse livsglæde og lykke.
In a way, we all take part in your joy and happiness as we follow the events of the day.
Derfor er forventningerne til dette bryllup så store. Og derfor tager vi alle
expectations for this wedding are great, and therefore we all will take part in the joy.
Et kongeligt brudepar tilhører nemlig ikke kun hinanden.
A royal couple does not only belong to each other, but to all of us.
Og det ved I.
That's what we feel, and you know it.
Og mange pligter venter forude.
Many obligations are awaiting you. And you will continue the Danish monarchy.
Den danske samfundsmodel, som vi regner for afgørende vigtigt at fastholde og forny i en tid præget af internationalisering og globalisering.
It's very important that you continue this moment in a time marked by internationalization and globalization.
Derfor er monarkiet så rodfæstet.
That's the reason why the monarchy is very strongly established in Denmark.
Hænger det sammen med, at vi har stor tillid til, at brud og brudgom er vel rustet og vel forberedt til de mange opgaver. Som søofficer har kronprins Frederik lært at leve op til Niels Juels valgsprog, nek temere, nek timidi, det vil sige hverken ubesindig eller frygtsom. Et valgsprog, som også Mary Donaldson til fulde
Bishop now is mentioning the motto of the school, who was nek temere, nek timidi, meaning neither reckless nor timid.
I det høje nord.
That's a motto for Crown Prince Frederik, he said.
Men selv for et kronprinsepar gælder det, at brud og brudgom først og sidst tilhører hinanden i medgang og modgang.
For Crown Prince and his bride, the first and the first thing and is to be close to each other. It's not good for a man to be alone, as it is written in the book.
Så intimt og gensidigt givende som i ægteskabet. Det forudsætter, at vi dagligt er opmærksomme på hinanden og giver plads. for hinanden.
We need to be attentive and allow each other the necessary space to talk confidentially. This peaceful space is difficult to reach in a modern society.
Kan lægge beslag på alle døgnets 24 timer. Ikke mindst for et kronprinsepar.
This is not less true of the crown prince and the princess who are unable to appear in public without being noticed and watched.
At vores kronprinsepar får fred.
We all, however, share the responsibility that our crown prince and princess will find the possibility to enjoy peace in each other's company, even when the honeymoon is over. Now he is addressing Mary Donaldson. You have come to us from far side of the earth, from the beautiful and mountainous Tasmania to the low-lying, lovely Denmark. Both countries have the imminent sea and the changing seasons. We are looking forward now to show you your new country when it's most beautiful and delightful summertime.
Turen går også nordpå, hvor de med egne øjne kan se, at kongeriget ikke kun er lavland, men også Grønland.
After your journeys will take you up north, see by your own eyes that not all of the kingdom of Denmark is lowland, but that it also includes Greenland and the Faroe Islands as part of the Danish kingdom with its own history, language and culture.
Og overalt vil de og kronprinsen blive modtaget med åbne arme.
Everywhere you and the crown prince will be received with open arms. From today, you are a real princess who has got both the prince and all the kingdom. We can almost continue with the words from the fairy tale, and they lived happily ever after. We all know from our life that not everything is like in the fairy tales. Joys and sorrows both belong to human life, as do good and evil days. We need one another and to be encouraged and comforted. Living happily has less to do with feeling that with life succeeding in something good and fruitful.
Først og fremmest i de nære og forpligtende forhold som ægteskab, venskab og slægtskab. Det er meningen med vores liv, sådan som det er blevet os betroet af livets Gud og skaber. For det er Gud, som har givet os livet og givet
Now,
os til hinanden.
The bishop is talking about God, who has granted us life and entrusted us with one another.
Af vor Herres ord, og det vil sige i kærlighed, sådan som vor Herre Jesus selv har sagt og gjort. Derfor lød skriftens formaning før, I skal iføre jer kærligheden, som er fuldkommenhedens bånd.
Therefore the exhaustion of the Holy Scripture says, above all, close yourself with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. That love embodies compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. It even makes us bear with and forgive one another.
Guds kærlighed, som møder os varmt og livgivende i Jesus Kristus, vil holde os fast på at ville den kærlighed.
Every time we fall short of our relations with other people, God will forgive us in his love and urge us to love again. Therefore, we worship at a wedding. We hope to be reviewed by the word of God so that we shall not be blinded by our capacity for worry and sadness.
Så vi ikke stiger os blinde på vores egne bekymringer og bedrøvelighed, men for livsmål af alt det, som Jesus.
We hope to regain hope from all the faith, hope and charity, which Jesus brought to the world.
Hver gang vi træder ind i dette kirkerum, bliver vi stærkt mindet herom, fordi alt i dette kirkerum samles i Kristusfiguren over alteret. Hovedet er bøjet og blikket sænket mod os. Når vi samles her ved alteret, ser vi ligesom Kristus ind i øjnene og ser ham med hænderne bredt modtagende ud. Kommer til mig, står der med store bogstaver.
It's like on the sculpture of Christ here by us, the sculpture done by Thorvaldsen, which is known in all words, other words by Jesus. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest.
Se, det ord er godt at have for øje i hele det brogede menneskeliv. Det kalder på os, når vi har allermest brug for det. Opfordringen om at komme til Kristus er ikke et løfte om en problemfri tilværelse, men et løfte om, at han vil være med os alle dage og bære med på vores byrder, både dem vi selv har ansvar for, og dem som andre måske uretfærdigt lægger på os. Hos ham kan vi alle finde hvile,
Christ will find peace even when life is troubled. To come to Christ is to accept love when it's most clear and pure, so we regain strength to live with the duties that we were entrusted with. Trusting this, we can begin both married life and even new day God gives us to life.
Gud vil sige jer. Amen.
Inden tilspørgelsen og vielsen synger Københavns drengekor, der
Once again, it's the Voice Choir of Copenhagen singing tæt kaldt Sigurd Servus, de siger det ret. See a proud Queen Margaret, Crown Prince Frederik, Mary Donaldson, shortly they will marry.
Thank you.
was the Copenhagen Boys Choir. And now, once again, the Bishop of Copenhagen and Mary Donaldson and Crown Prince Frederik. The real historical moment, so to speak.
Så tilspørger jeg dig, Frederik André Henrik Christian.
I now ask you, Frederik André Henrik Christian, will you take Mary Elizabeth Donaldson standing by your side to be your wife? The answer, I will. Will you love and honor her and live with her in prosperity and adversity, in what future God, the Almighty, will send you as a husband should live with his wedded wife until death parts you? The answer, I will. Likewise, I ask you, Mary Elizabeth Donaldson, will you take Father André Henrik Christian standing by your side to be your husband? She said, yeah. Will you love and honor him and live with him in prosperity and adversity, in what fortune God, the Almighty, will send you, as your wife should live with her wedded husband until death pass you? I will. Then join your hands together. Since you have promised one another that you live together in marriage, and have now confirmed this before God, and before us who are present, I declare you to be man and wife before God and all mankind.
I Faderens og Sønnens og Helligåndens navn. Amen.
Amen.
Giv hinanden disse ringe som tegn på jeres ægteskab. Lad os alle bede.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, grant this man and this woman grace, happiness, and blessing in soul and body. Grant they might love one another with faithful love and serve you sincerely in all things, that they might live as your dear children and finally be gathered unto you in the eternal mansion.
Giv os i dag vores daglige brød, og forlad os vores skyld, som også vi forlader vores skyldnere. Og led os ikke i fristelse, men fri os fra det onde. Til dit er riget, og magten og æren i evighed. Amen. Fred være med jer. Amen.
Peace be with you. Amen was the last word of the bishop. And now it's the crown princess and the crown prince. Now Mary Donaldson is the crown princess. That's her official title in the royal Danish family. More music will follow shortly. Oh. Simply Prayer is the name. This piece of music. Next hymn will be a hymn that is nearly always part of a Lutheran wedding in Denmark. It's called How Sweetly Beckons the Path Ahead. It's written by N.F.S. Grundtvig in the year of 1855. Next hymn to follow, beautiful one, nearly always part of a wedding in Denmark. now is the chaplain royal, Professor Christian Todberg, who will say prayers, the collect and the benediction. Another part of the Lutheran tradition.
Lad os bede. Gud bevar vor dronning. Iklæd dine tjenere retfærdighed. O Herre, frels dit folk. Giv fred i vore dage, Herre. Gud, skab rene hjerter i os. Hvor Guds navn skære. Lad os alle bede. Vi takker dig, kære himmelske Fader, fordi du har indstiftet ægteskabet. Og vi beder dig, at du vil bevare denne din ordning og velsignelse, urokket også iblandt os. Giv alle kristne ægte folk ved din Helligånd, at de må hjælpe hinanden at holde fast ved din frelsende nåde. Gør dem glade i håbet, tålmodige i trængslen og udholdende i bønnen, og styrk dem til at være levende lemmer af din hellige menighed, så at de en gang med den kan samles hos dig i dit rige. Velsigne dig og bevare dig. Herren lade sit ansigt lyse over dig og være dig nådig. Herren løfte sit åsyn på dig og give dig fred.
Now, the last hymn from in this wedding will be coming up now. It's the hymn, Now Thank We All Our God, as well, traditional part in Danish weddings. The last hymn for this historical royal wedding in Copenhagen. Really a big chapter in the fairy tale, not a fairy tale by Hans Christian Andersen, but from the real life. A 32-year-old Australian girl has married a real prince, crown prince in Denmark, the oldest monarchy in Europe. That is the fairy tale from the real life. Now the bridesmaids will help their sister out. It's been a very beautiful ceremony. And while the newlywed are ready to leave the Cathedral of Copenhagen, can just tell you that next part of the royal program here in Copenhagen this Friday afternoon will be the ride by the coach. Of the church in Copenhagen. Officers from the naval forces outside. And of course, once again, Danes waving with Australian and Danish flags. The city of Copenhagen, as you can see, we are lucky in Copenhagen. No rain, not sunshine anyway, but at least it's possible to make this carriage drive in an open carriage. What you see here is the Royal Danish Guard Hussar Regiment. The Royal Danish Guard Hussar Regiment has always taken part in royal events. And now what you see here is the mounted squadron of the regiment that will escort Crown Prince Frederik and now Crown Princess Mary Donaldson from the cathedral to Amalienborg Palace. The escort will include the regiment's standard and some 50 horses. This is the open coach you have here. Without the help from her sisters, I'm sure Mayor Donaldson would have problems with her dress. And the flowers, of course. And as you can see now, the Garda Hussars, they are all wearing the red full dress uniform. The coach will now pass through the narrow streets in the center of the old Copenhagen, heading for Amalienborg Palace. This is the coach, right? The real name of that coach carrying the young couple, the real name, it's known as Eberusch. It was originally built in Berlin in the year of 1906, nearly 100 years ago. And this coach was also used at the wedding of Queen Margrethe and Prince Henrik in June 1967. So the same coach, the Barouche, that was used 1967 for the wedding of Queen Margrethe. There are exactly 48 horses in this escort. The way here, heading for Amalienborg Palace. The couple will cross the City Hall Square. That'll be a little bit later. As we told you earlier this afternoon in Denmark, we told you that next coming up is the balcony scene at Amalienborg Palace. From then, the young couple and the guest will go to Frederiksborg Palace to have the wedding dinner tonight, and then it will all be a big party ending with the fireworks. Local time, Denmark, 12 o'clock, which for the moment now is 5 hours. It's 7 hours ahead of us. So still long program ahead of us. after passing the City Hall Square, the coach is going on in the narrow streets of the city of Copenhagen. 48 horses. I mean, even if there's a kind of special security in Copenhagen in connection with the wedding, it is possible for Danes to, as you can see, be pretty close to the royals. It is a Danish tradition for the royals to be so close to normal people. The old square in Copenhagen with the fountain, where you have the golden apples in the fountain. It's one of the famous, well-known squares in Copenhagen. Old square, in Danish called Gammeltorv. You have the high court building in the background. In Denmark, tonight after this wedding here. Many Danes, they will celebrate the wedding privately, or and others, they will go to restaurants, inns, hotels across Denmark, because many places there are offers on special royal wedding menus, where you can have menus with Australian wine, going with Australian wine as well. So that's something that many, many Danes will do today, to this evening, since it's Friday and Saturday. Tomorrow is a day off, a normal day off. It's the weekend in Denmark. So there will be many Danish-Australian dinners tonight, not only in Copenhagen, all over Denmark. As well, you have seen in many Danish supermarkets the last couple of days, you have seen Australian wine, you have seen specialities from Australia, meat from Australia. So in a way, it's a good possibility for Australia to marketing products from down under in Denmark, and maybe the other way around as well. Underway at the Amager Square, another famous fountain in Copenhagen as well. You see the building for Georg Jensen, famous juvelier, silver artist. Among the many, many, many gifts that has been given to Crown Prince Frederik and Mary is a Flora Danica set, which is part of a kind of people's gift for the couple. That Flora Danica set was handed over to the couple before the wedding, and beside from that, porcelain, the second gift from the Danish people, was a ballad that was composed and performed in English by a gentleman called Iran D.D. And the name of this CD, the ballad, was When You Hold Me, and that was presented for the royal couple at a special gala performance in Tivoli Gardens before the wedding. Other gifts, more official in a way, is from Australia itself. Australia has given three trees that comes from Tasmania. It's been sent to Denmark and is now planted at Fredensborg Palace, where Frederik and Mary will live and have their residence part of the time. That's the Royal Theatre you have there. Last night there was a gala performance for the royal family and for the guests from all over Europe and from Australia as well. A gala performance there. One of the artists on stage was the singer Donovan. This part of Copenhagen has been or is undergoing renovation because next year it will be 200 years since Hans Christian Andersen was born, and there will be so many celebrations around Denmark and especially in the capital of Copenhagen next year for this bicentennial for Hans Christian Andersen's birth. And part of that renovation has been finished and there's still something to do. And that will, of course, will be done after the wedding and after the royal fever is over again. Right now you are we are at the Marienborg Square, at the Marienborg Palace. Coates has arrived there. One of the highlights of this royal wedding show today. As you can see, tens of thousands of Danes are gathering here. Still nice weather in Copenhagen. Time is close to 6 p.m. Wife now, Crown Princess Mary. Once again, getting a hand from her sisters and her best girlfriend. Marienborg Palace is the is the winter residence of the royals in Denmark. Summertime, sometimes they are in Norway, sometimes they are up north at Fredensborg, but during winter time, this is the place where the royals they stay. There are four Renaissance-style symmetric mansions here at the palace. They're all built between 1750 and 1760 and was built that time for the nobility in Denmark. The royal family lived here until it was destroyed by a fire. And then fire was in Christiansborg Castle, and meaning that this palace here, Marienborg, was the residence from 1794. And the mansions here, before them there, have names of the Danish kings. In the middle of the square, there's a statue, a big statue of Prince King Frederik the Fifth. It's done by a French sculptor, Jacques-François Joseph Sally. There you can see the crowd is trying to enter the square. And half of the guests who were in the church in the Copenhagen Cathedral, the world have a guest there, half of them will now be undressed, refreshed, or whatever, before they will go to the royal wedding dinner, which is at Frederiksborg Palace tonight.
Det er ikke noget sædvanligt.
Shortly the doors will open to the balcony at the Marienborg Palace and you will get the balcony scene, another chapter in the fairy tale. Some have got a very good view from one of the ferries. It's the ferries to Norway, one of the ferries to Norway from Copenhagen, just at anchor behind the Amalienborg Palace and the square there. And as you can see in the bottom from this aerial shot, people are like ants approaching the square, running from the narrow streets where they followed the coach on the way from the Cathedral of Copenhagen, now trying to reach the square here at the Marienborg to get a view of the newlyweds. Thank you. random countdown for the balcony scene. And it will then take place approximately or shortly after 6 p.m. in Copenhagen. Maybe it was just a rehearsal. This is a tradition in Denmark with these balcony scene, not only at weddings, but when the Queen Margaret has her birthday, there's always a balcony scene, and thousands of Danes, tens of thousands of Danes are gathered here, same place, and the Queen is always coming out waving, bringing her family with her, and that's a kind of tradition in Denmark. And of course, when there's a wedding that will take place, this balcony scene is an important part of the events on the wedding day. And there you are, there you go. There you get it. The first kiss on the balcony. Yeah. There you have the entire family, six main persons here you have, beside from Crown Prince Frederik, Crown Princess Mary, you have Queen Margaret of Denmark, Prince Henrik, you have John, and you have Susan Donaldson from Hobart, Tasmania. Cameras are set up, as you can see, in the City Hall Square, the big screen there as well. So people are gathering there to have on the big screen in front of the City Hall the shots from the balcony, which is some 2 kilometers away from it. There are many places around in Denmark, big screens set up today. People are gathering to follow the events following the wedding. Prince Frederik, dressed in his scarlet uniform of the Navy and still wearing the Grand Order of the Elephant with the Star of the Order and the Cross of the Grand Commander with the Star of the Order and other decorations. Another kiss. All we know about the honeymoon is, I mean, we don't know what will go on for the next days, but we know next month the couple will go on the Royal Yacht Danebro up north. They will visit the Faroe Islands, they'll visit Greenland, and as well they will visited many small cities around, harbors around in Denmark. The first trip as married couple on Dannebrog, which is the name of the Royal Yacht. And for Mayor Donaldson, it will be her first visit to the Faroe Islands and to Greenland. Seems to be a lot of kisses in the royal family today. So now there's Tasmanian blood in the Danish family. Like the Queen's husband, who's French, Prince Joachim's wife is born in Hong Kong. Now the Crown Prince is married to an Australian, to a Tasmanian girl. Once again, making the Royal Danish family pretty international. You can see he's wearing his ring on his left hand. The rings, the exchange in the cathedral. It's made, by the way, by the first gold from Greenland. Some 70 grams of gold found on Greenland has been used for these royal rings. And the door will close, but not forever. We wouldn't be too surprised if it will open up again. Around here in the square, you see soldiers dressed in red gala uniforms. That's the Royal Danish Life Guards. They are full dressed today in gala uniform. And this Royal Danish Life Guard is a part, really established part of the Royal Danish family's life. As we said, we wouldn't be that surprised if the door goes up once again. This Amalienborg Palace is always guarded, and it is the Danish lifeguards. It's a part of the duties for this lifeguard. And on occasions of state visits, the Royal Danish Guard has a band with a corps of drums, and that will always be presented for the guest coming to Denmark, like it has been today for the wedding. Out we go once again.